Hello everyone, welcome to the English Devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let's begin in prayer. Blessed Heavenly Father, I glorify you for this Sabbath day that you have given us. Thank you, Father, that we can find rest, spiritual rest in you today. Thank you that today is the day that we do not focus on work or school or the worries and cares of this world, that we can focus all of our time and our energy on you. Father, I thank you and I praise you. I ask you, Lord, that if there is anything in my life that does not please you, you will forgive me and wash me white as snow. Father, so that my prayer can enter the sweetness of your heavenly kingdom and you can listen to my petitions. Father God, thank you so much for your love towards us. Thank you, Father God, that we can lay our burdens down at your feet and you take them on willingly. Thank you so much that we can call upon your name and you answer us. Thank you for being near to the brokenhearted. Thank you for your provision. Thank you for your safety and your shelter that you provide. Father, I ask that this devotional will be a blessing for those who are listening, for those who are sharing it, Lord. Thank you, and I praise you. Thank you for all the hands that go into preparing these devotional, from the translation to sending it out on social media to creating the PowerPoints and slides and putting everything together. I thank you and I praise you, Father God, for meeting this great need. Father, these things I pray in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Today's devotional is titled, Keep Crying Out. It was written by Nady Letty Gonzalez and translated by Stacy Martinez. Our biblical base today is found in Jeremiah 33, verse 3. So says the Word of God. Call to me, and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you do not know. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the Scripture. Children have a very unique method for making their parents give them what they want. They simply repeat their request over and over again, and it works. This is because, in most cases, their insistence eventually convinces their parents to give them what they are asking for. If this is the case with our earthly parents, who are flawed and imperfect, how much more will our Heavenly Father, who is so gracious, do for us, His children? This does not mean that we have to be constantly on our knees bringing our requests before God. Sometimes what we ask for takes time, and while we wait, the Lord recommends that we continue to cry out to Him so that we do not despair or become restless. The secret lies in crying out to God, because when we do, we are drawing nearer to Him. This not only guarantees that our request will be granted, but that along with it, He will also graciously give us all things, as it says in Psalms 23:1. Do not hesitate. Don't grow weary. Keep crying out. Amen. My brothers and sisters, God wants you. He invites you to cry out to Him with your petitions. Cry out to Him for the salvation of those that you love. Cry out to Him in the situations at work that seem impossible. Cry out to Him for healing of your spiritual, physical, and emotional health. Cry out to Him for that wayward child who has walked away, that God will touch their heart in a special way and bring them to Him. Cry out to Him for your finances, for your marriage, for your relationships, for your future. Cry out to Him and He will answer you. He is going to show you great and mighty things, things that you do not already know. That is a promise, my brothers and sisters. And why do we keep asking God for these things? We do it more for us than for Him. Did you know that? When we ask God for something, He remembers our petitions. We keep asking God and calling out to Him because that is how we can prevent ourselves from getting discouraged and despairing and becoming restless. God remembers our petitions. He remembers our worries. He remembers the state of our heart when we cry out to Him. He doesn't need reminding of our petitions. It is for our spiritual benefit that we keep crying out to Him. My brothers and sisters, God is giving you an invitation today. No matter what your burden is, no matter how your situation seems so impossible and without solution, God wants you and He's inviting you to cry out to Him, to lay your burdens at His feet where they belong, so you will find rest and He will answer your prayer according to His riches and His glory. So don't hesitate, my brothers and sisters. Continue crying out to your Heavenly Father. You don't worry Him, you don't burden Him, and you are not too much for Him. He can handle it, so cry out. Amen. May the Lord receive the honor and the glory.
reach out, you just cry out to Jesus, cry to Jesus. To the widow who suffers from being alone, wiping the tears from her eyes, and for the children around the world without a home, say a prayer tonight. There is hope for the helpless, rest for the weary, and love for the broken heart. There is grace and forgiveness, mercy and healing. He'll meet you wherever you are. There is hope for the helpless, rest for the weary, and love for the broken heart. There is grace and forgiveness, mercy and healing. He'll meet you wherever you are. Cry out to Jesus.
What a beautiful song. Now, my brothers and sisters, I invite you to continue listening to our daily Bible reading, where in 1 year, we're going to go through the entire Bible. And today's biblical reading comes from Colossians 1 through 4 and 1 Thessalonians chapter 1. So says the Word of God.
The Epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Colossians, chapter 1. Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ by the will of God, and Timothy our brother, to the saints and faithful brethren in Christ who are in Colossae. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. We give thanks to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, praying always for you, since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of your love for all the saints. Because of the hope which is laid up for you in heaven, of which you heard before in the word of the truth of the gospel, which has come to you as it has also in all the world and is bringing forth fruit, as it is also among you since the day you heard and knew the grace of God in truth. As you also learned from Epaphras, our dear fellow servant, who is a faithful minister of Christ on your behalf, who also declared to us your love in the Spirit. For this reason, we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you, and to ask that you may be filled with the knowledge of His will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that you may walk worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing Him, being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God, strengthened with all might, according to His glorious power, for all patience and long-suffering with joy, giving thanks to the Father, who has qualified us to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. He has delivered us from the power of darkness and conveyed us into the kingdom of the Son of His love, in whom we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of sins. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. For by Him all things were created that are in heaven and that are on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. All things were created through Him and for Him. And He is before all things, and in Him all things consist. And He is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things He may have the preeminence. For it pleased the Father that in Him all the fullness should dwell, and by Him to reconcile all things to Himself, by him, whether things on earth or things in heaven, having made peace through the blood of his cross. And you, who once were alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now he has reconciled, in the body of his flesh through death, to present you holy and blameless and above reproach in his sight. If indeed you continue in the faith, grounded and steadfast, and are not moved away from the hope of the gospel which you heard, which was preached to every creature under heaven, of which I, Paul, became a minister. I now rejoice in my sufferings for you, and fill up in my flesh what is lacking in the afflictions of Christ, for the sake of his body, which is the church, of which I became a minister, according to the stewardship from God, which was given to me for you to fulfill the word of God. The mystery, which has been hidden from ages and from generations, but now has been revealed to his saints. To them God willed to make known what are the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Him we preach, warning every man and teaching every man in all wisdom, that we may present every man perfect in Christ Jesus. To this end I also labor, striving according to his working, which works in me mightily. Chapter 2. For I want you to know what a great conflict I have for you and those in Laodicea, and for as many as have not seen my face in the flesh, that their hearts may be encouraged, being knit together in love, and attaining to all riches of the full assurance of understanding, to the knowledge of the mystery of God, both of the Father and of Christ, in whom are hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. Now this I say, lest anyone should deceive you with persuasive words. For though I am absent in the flesh, yet I am with you in spirit, rejoicing to see your good order and the steadfastness of your faith in Christ. As you therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in him, rooted and built up in him, and established in the faith, as you have been taught, abounding in it with thanksgiving. Beware lest anyone cheat you through philosophy and empty deceit, according to the tradition of men, according to the basic principles of the world, and not according to Christ. For in him dwells all the fullness of the Godhead bodily, and you are complete in him, who is the head of all principality and power. In him you were also circumcised with a circumcision made without hands, by putting off the body of the sins of the flesh, by the circumcision of Christ, buried with him in baptism, in which you also were raised with him through faith in the working of God, who raised him from the dead. And you, being dead in your trespasses and the uncircumcision of your flesh, he has made alive together with him, having forgiven you all trespasses, having wiped out the handwriting of requirements that was against us, which was contrary to us. And he has taken it out of the way, having nailed it to the cross. Having disarmed principalities and powers, he made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them in it. So let no one judge you in food or in drink, or regarding a festival or a new moon or Sabbaths, which are a shadow of things to come, but the substance is of Christ. Let no one cheat you of your reward, taking delight in false humility and worship of angels, intruding into those things which he has not seen, vainly puffed up by his fleshly mind, and not holding fast to the head, from whom all the body, nourished and knit together by joints and ligaments, grows with the increase that is from God. Therefore, if you died with Christ from the basic principles of the world, why, as though living in the world, do you subject yourselves to regulations? Do not touch, do not taste, do not handle, which all concern things which perish with the using, according to the commandments and doctrines of men. These things indeed have an appearance of wisdom in self-imposed religion, false humility and neglect of the body, but are of no value against the indulgence of the flesh. Chapter 3. If then you were raised with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ is, sitting at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things above, not on things on the earth. For you died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. Therefore put to death your members which are on the earth, fornication, uncleanness, passion, evil desire, and covetousness, which is idolatry. Because of these things, the wrath of God is coming upon the sons of disobedience, in which you yourselves once walked when you lived in them. But now you yourselves are to put off all these, anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy language out of your mouth. Do not lie to one another, since you have put off the old man with his deeds, and have put on the new man, who is renewed in knowledge according to the image of him who created him, where there is neither Greek nor Jew, circumcised nor uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave nor free, but Christ is all and in all. Therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, put on tender mercies, kindness, humility, meekness, long-suffering, bearing with one another and forgiving one another, if anyone has a complaint against another, even as Christ forgave you, so you also must do. But above all these things, put on love, which is the bond of perfection, and let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which also you were called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. And whatever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Wives, submit to your own husbands, as is fitting in the Lord. Husbands, love your wives, and do not be bitter toward them. Children, obey your parents in all things, for this is well-pleasing to the Lord. Fathers, do not provoke your children, lest they become discouraged. Bondservants, obey in all things your masters according to the flesh, not with eye service, as men-pleasers, but in sincerity of heart, fearing God. And whatever you do, do it heartily, as to the Lord and not to men, knowing that from the Lord you will receive the reward of the inheritance, for you serve the Lord Christ. But he who does wrong will be repaid for what he has done, and there is no partiality. Chapter 4. Masters, give your bondservants what is just and fair, knowing that you also have a master in heaven. Continue earnestly in prayer, being vigilant in it with thanksgiving. Meanwhile, praying also for us, that God would open to us a door for the word, to speak the mystery of Christ, for which I am also in chains, that I may make it manifest as I ought to speak. Walk in wisdom toward those who are outside, redeeming the time. Let your speech always be with grace, seasoned with salt, that you may know how you ought to answer each one. Tychicus, a beloved brother, faithful minister, and fellow servant in the Lord, will tell you all the news about me. I am sending him to you for this very purpose, that he may know your circumstances and comfort your hearts. With Onesimus, a faithful and beloved brother, who is one of you, they will make known to you all things which are happening here. Aristarchus, my fellow prisoner, greets you, with Mark, the cousin of Barnabas, about whom you received instructions. If he comes to you, welcome him. And Jesus, who is called Justice. These are my only fellow workers for the kingdom of God, who are of the circumcision. They have proved to be a comfort to me. Epaphras, who is one of you, a bondservant of Christ, greets you, always laboring fervently for you in prayers, that you may stand perfect and complete in all the will of God. For I bear him witness that he has a great zeal for you, and those who are in Laodicea, and those in Hierapolis. Luke, the beloved physician, and Demas greet you. Greet the brethren who are in Laodicea, and Nymphas, and the church that is in his house. Now when this epistle is read among you, see that it is read also in the church of the Laodiceans, and that you likewise read the epistle from Laodicea, and say to Archippus, take heed to the ministry which you have received in the Lord, that you may fulfill it. This salutation by my own hand, Paul, remember my chains. Grace be with you. The first epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Thessalonians. Chapter 1. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, to the Church of the Thessalonians in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace to you, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. We give thanks to God always for you all, making mention of you in our prayers, remembering without ceasing your work of faith, labor of love, and patience of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ, in the sight of our God and Father, knowing, beloved brethren, your election by God. For our gospel did not come to you in word only, but also in power, and in the Holy Spirit, and in much assurance, as you know what kind of men we were among you for your sake. And you became followers of us and of the Lord, having received the word in much affliction, with joy of the Holy Spirit, so that you became examples to all in Macedonia and Achaia who believe. For from you the word of the Lord has sounded forth, not only in Macedonia and Achaia, but also in every place. Your faith toward God has gone out, so that we do not need to say anything. For they themselves declare concerning us what manner of entry we had to you, and how you turned to God from idols to serve the living and true God, and to wait for his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, even Jesus, who delivers us from the wrath to come.
Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scripture. My brothers and sisters, keep crying out to the Heavenly Father. He loves you and he wants to hear from you. No matter the situation, no matter where you find yourselves, what mountain or valley, dark or light that you are in right now, he wants you to cry out to him. So do it, my brothers and sisters. Find rest for your souls at the foot of the cross. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children, now and forever. Amen.